is small and furry, it can be pretty cute, and it flies around at night. Can you guess what animal it is?
A bat.
That's right. You guessed it. Bats are awesome. I have three facts I would like to tell you about bats. To start off, bats can hear their way in the dark. They don't rely on their eyes like we do. They use sound to find their way around. The sound they make during the night, they listen to it and it echoes back. And the way it echoes comes back to them tells them how far or close an animal is. And this is called echolocation. And another thing about bats is they like to hang upside down. And they can hang for a long period of time because their bodies are made for hanging upside down. But you know what I love about bats? Is they make really great moms. So today, I'd like for all of you to be able to describe the overall structure of a story. Describe them how the beginning takes place and introduces the story, and how the ending concludes the action. I've got this great book. It's about a brood bat. And one night, this baby bat gets lost, and her whole world turns upside down. And the book in the back is called Stella Luna, and it's by Janelle Cannon. One night, as Mother Bat followed the heavy scent of ripe fruit, an owl spied her. On silent wings, the power bird swooped down upon the bats, dodging and shrieking. Mother Bat tried to escape, but the owl struck again and again, knocking Stella Luna to the air. Her baby wings were as limp and useless as wet paper. Down, down she went, faster and faster into the forest below. Oh, poor little Stella Luna. The dark, leafy tangle of branches caught Stella Luna as she fell. One twig was small enough for Stella Luna's tiny feet, wrapping her wings about her. She clutched the thin branch, trembling with cold and fear. Mother, Stella Luna squeaked, where are you? By daybreak, the baby bat could hold on no longer. Down, down again, she dropped. That's so sad, isn't it? Flop! Stella Luna landed headfirst in a soft, downy nest, startling the three baby birds who lived there. Stella Luna quickly clambered from the nest and hung out of sight below it. She listened to the babble of the three birds.
What was that?
Cried Flap.
I don't know,
but it's hanging by its feet, chirped Flitter.
Shh, here comes Mama, hissed Pip.
Many, many times that day, Mama Bird flew away, always returning with food for her babies. Stella Luna was terribly hungry, but not for those crawly things Mama Bird brought. Finally, though the little bat could bear it no longer, she climbed into the nest, closed her eyes, and opened her mouth. Plop! And a drop big green grasshopper. Stella Luna learned to be like the birds. She stayed awake all day and slept at night. She ate bugs even though they tasted awful. Her bat ways were quickly disappearing, except for one thing. Stella Luna still liked to sleep, hanging by her feet. Once when Mama was away, the curious baby birds decided to try it too. When Mama Bird came home, she saw eight tiny feet gripping the edge of the nest. She cried, "Get back up here this instant! You're going to fall and break your necks!" The birds clambered back into the nest, but Mama Bird stopped Stella Luna. "You are teaching my children to do bad things. I will not let you back into this nest unless you promise to obey all the rules of this house." Stella Luna promised. She ate bugs without making faces. She slept in the nest at night, and she didn't hang by her feet. Stella Luna behaved as a good bird should. Pip, Flitter, and Flap landed gracefully on a branch. Stella Luna tried to do the same. Oh, she can't land like that. How embarrassing. I will fly all day, Stella Luna told herself. that no one will see how clumsy I am. All alone, Stellina flew and flew until her wings ached and she dropped into a tree. I promised not to hang by my feet, Stellina sighed, so she hung by her thumbs and soon fell asleep. She didn't hear the soft sound of wings coming near.
I wonder what it is.
Wonder what it is.
I did.
Ow! Hey!
A loud voice said, why are you hanging upside down? Stella Luna's eyes opened wide. She saw a most peculiar face. I'm not upside down, you are, Stella Luna said. But you're a bat. Bats hang by their feet. You are hanging by your thumb, so that makes you upside down, the creature said. More bats gathered around to see the strange young bat who behaved like a bird. Stella Luna told them her story. You ate bugs, stuttered one. You slept that night, gasped another. How very strange, they all murmured. Wait, let me look at this child. A bat pushed through the crowd. An owl attacked you? She asked, sniffing Stella Luna's fur. She whispered, you're Stella Luna. You're my baby. You escaped the owl, cried Stella Luna. You survived? Yes, said Mother Bat as she wrapped her wings around Stella Luna. Come with me and I'll show you where to find the most delicious fruit. You'll never have to eat another bug as long as you live. But it's nighttime, Stella Luna squeaked. We can't fly in the dark or we will crash into trees. We're bats, said Mother Bat. We can see in the darkness. Come with us. Stella Luna was afraid, but she let go of the tree and dropped into the deep blue sky. Stella Luna could see. She felt as though rays of light shone from her eyes. She was able to see everything in her path. Soon the bats found a mango tree and Stella Luna ate as much of the fruit she could. Hold. I'll never eat another bug as long as I live, cheered Stella Luna as she stuffed herself full. I must tell Pip, Flitter, and Flab. How can we be so different and feel so much alike, mused Flitter. And how can we feel so different and be so much alike, wondered Pip. I think this is quite a mystery, flapped Chirp. I agree, said Stella Luna, but we're friends, and that's a fact.
That's a fact.
So, let me ask you a question. What happened in the beginning, Casey?
The mom of Stella Luna, she got attacked by the owl.
That's right. Okay, what happened at the end of the...
The mom found Stella Luna and she had to rescue her three brother and sister birds.
Good job. Well, did y'all like the book about Stella Luna?
Yeah.
Great. Y'all did such a good job listening. Thank you so much.